Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the special episode of Algae Corner out in the field with me, Dr. West Bishop. Now, what we're going to cover today is a specific on-site assessment. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to look at some questions to ask and things to look for when you go to a specific site to help us develop a prescription for that site. So we want to see what we're up against in terms of management, the intensity of management, the need for management, and is this something that's going to be a long-term program or something pretty quickly we can get in check. All right, so first thing we look for when we go up to a site that I like to see is, what is the source of water? What are those inflows of water coming into a system? Is it filled by well water? Is it spring fed? Is there spring water coming in? Is there a stream or a ditch or a canal or a lateral that's bringing water into that pond or lake system? Is the water body sitting down low? Is it sunken in the earth, or is it sitting above everything else around it? So that the inflow sources, where's the water coming from to fill up the pond, is very important. All right, next is the watershed. So that watershed around it, how big is the watershed? Where that water's coming from that flows in, and what's it covered by? Is that watershed grass, for example? Is that grass cut? Are the grass clippings blown into the system? Is it surrounded by trees? Do those leaves fall down and get blown into that water body too? Or is it pasture land? Is there horses or cows upstream from your water body? Maybe it's agricultural land. You know, what types of crops are they growing? How often do they fertilize it? Does that fertilizer, you know, flush down into the system? Or maybe it's residential. Do you just have a lot of houses around there? Maybe it's industrial. Do you have businesses and parking lots, a lot of impervious surfaces? But, you know, good to understand what the watershed is around that pond that may flow into that water body to let us know what we're up against in terms of management. Now, the other thing to look for around that pond or lake system is the soil type. Now, is it real organic? Is it peat, moss, and mucky organic? Or is it more sandy, silty, clay, or rocks around the system that are coming in? All right, the next thing to look for in the on-site assessment is the buffer zone. Is there a buffer of plants around the edge of the pond? If so, how much of the area of the pond does it cover? Is it near the inflows, or is it just a small section of the pond, or is it around the entire pond? What's that buffer zone comprised of? Is it woody plants or vegetative plants? Are they potentially invasive or nuisance species like cattails or bulrush or phragmites? Or is it beneficial native plants that make up that buffer zone around the edge? So again, understanding that buffer, how big it is, where it's at, what it's comprised of, very important in that on-site assessment. All right, next up, things I look at are the water appearance. Now, is that water clean and clear and pristine, or is it real murky and brown, or does it have algal mats and scums built up in it? If so, how long has it been like that? Does it get worse after a rain, or do you see a seasonality in the algal growth factors in that water appearance or the discoloration, or has it been pretty constant for a long time in the water body? All right, the other thing we look at in this on-site assessment is wildlife. What type of animals are in the system? Do you see a lot of geese and ducks flying in, or swans? Are they, you know, bringing a lot of nutrients with them, with their feces? Do you have muskrats or beavers in there? Even the fish, do you have a diverse array of different types of fish and sizes in there, or is it just mainly one type? Do you have a lot of carp and catfish, or is it more, you know, trout and goldfish in there? Are those fish fed? Are they fed, you know, by hand, or is there a machine feeder that feeds those fish, or are they just, you know, left there to innately fend for themselves? Those are important things to ask when it comes to the on-site assessment. So, in summary today, we covered multiple factors involved in that initial on-site assessment. Now, this can be extremely valuable in helping categorize your pond or lake system and really informing us on the direction of management, the need for management, and the intensity of management to get that pond or lake system on the right track. Please visit cpro.com to find your local aquatic specialists to help you out with your pond or lake system. Thank you.